Morning. So last class we started with the religion called Buddhism. So as you all know, in Buddhism we talked regarding the founder, that is Gautama Buddha. So about Gautama Buddha's lifestyle we had discussed in the previous classes. Then we had started with the a concept called division of Buddhism, that is Hinayana and Mahayana. And after that we talked about the spread of Buddhism. So right now the religion called Buddhism, so where and all it is spread. So that also we had discussed in the previous class. Then we started with the very important topic of the lesson. So that was doctrine of Buddhism. So this we had started. And in that, one of the doctrine of Buddhism, one of the most important teachings of Buddha, I mean, we had seen it in the previous class, that was the Four Noble Truths. So when we had seen Four Noble Truths, so according to Gautama Buddha, the suffering is a common or a unique thing in this world. And the suffering takes place because of the human desire. Okay, so according to Gautama Buddha, a man is having a desire, so that is the reason the suffering is coming across, or man comes across the suffering. So that was the state of, mind, so which he had given after the enlightenment, or after receiving an enlightenment or the higher knowledge, so he had given this message. So at the same time he says, if you want to overcome your sufferings, or if you want to have good deeds of life, so he asks us to follow the concept called Eightfold Path. Okay, or we call it as an Ashtamagga. Okay, the Eightfold Path. So which the Gautama Buddha says. So here I have just given a diagram of an Eightfold Path. How the Eightfold Path is the diagram, here it is there. So we will go one by one. Not in detail, but the major concepts, so we will be having it. So the first one we are having, so that is right belief. So that is the first, the path which, Gautama Buddha says you need to follow it. So according to, Gautama Buddha, right belief means what? Okay, or if you say, so Gautama Buddha, mainly he says, the religion should be based on a right, faith. That is, blind faith should not have for a person. That is the thing he wanted to say in this first concept. So according to Gautama Buddha, a person should have a right faith, okay, right belief, than the blind faith. So he is asking us to not to have a blind faith. Okay, so not to have a blind faith or blind belief. So that is the, right belief says. Then the second one, we are having, that is right thought. So according to Gautama Buddha, so right thought, that means nothing but right attitude. A person should have a right attitude. Okay, to right attitude to judge anything. Okay, right thought. Okay, right attitude. A person should be judged with an attitude of right thing. So this he says in the right thought. Okay, because always a person's behavior. Attitude is nothing but the behavior. Okay, the attitude is nothing but the behavior. Or we ourselves represent. So our representation should always be the right attitude, which will allow us to have a proper judge. Okay, that is the third, second one says. Then the third one, if you see, that is a right speech. Okay, so right speech. So that is the third thing which we are having. So Gautama Buddha says, speak always truth. Okay, he says speak truth. Then, so avoid gossip. Okay, speak truth. Be honest. Be truthful. Don't don't let your ears for a gossip. Okay, this is the thing. So which he says in the right third one. Then the fourth one he says is, that is right action. Okay, so right action in the sense, your life should have an harmony. You should stand for harmony. After your death, people should speak about, good things about the person who is dead, or the person who is, or the person who is died. So about them, particularly the harmony. Okay, that particular, concept should be there. You should be a person for the path of ahimsa, or the path of peace. Okay, so here, especially he says, or he stressed that, to follow a path of ahimsa. It means being away from killing of animals, or being, compassion towards living beings. All the things he says, that is a peace. So mainly, harmony is nothing but peace, he says in that particular. Then fifth one, we are having right means of livelihood. Okay, so livelihood is nothing but, when you lead in your life, you avoid cause of harm. Don't harm any personalities. Okay, don't harm anyone. By harming a person or harming something, so you need not live a life. But if you harm and if you lead your life, or if you cause an harm to a person, so that is not a rightful, lifestyle you are going to have. So without harming either a human being or either living beings or creatures, whatever it may be, you need to have a lifestyle. That is the right meaningful way of leading your life. Okay, that's the one thing, so he says. Then the sixth one we are having, so that is right meditation. So according to, Gautama Buddha, through this right meditation, he says that every person should have awareness on our body. Okay, the meditation we do it because to have an awareness towards our, body, and to control the feelings. Okay, in order to make, always a person should have awareness towards his, body. That you can get it only through the right meditation. And you can overcome your feelings only through right of meditation. The feelings can be of positive, or it can be of negative, whatever it may be. But the right meditation, he asks us. Then seventh one he says is, that is right effort. Okay, always achieve something in your life with a positive, positive states of mind. Whatever effort you make, or whatever the thing achieve in your life, that should have a right effort. Okay, we can say right path, I can say. Okay, instead of taking a wrong path or wrong direction. So in your life, have a right path to reach your destination. So that he says with a right effort. And the last one is right remembrance, or we also call it as a right memory. Okay, right remembrance, or memory we call it. So that says that a person should have a mental focus. Okay, so a person should have mental focus. It's very important. Okay, our deeds always should carry out based on the mind. Okay, that is so mind is very important part, so which makes our desire. Okay, so all these things, all this eightfold path, if you want your desire, only it says about our desire. If you want to achieve your desire, you follow these eightfold paths. So if you follow these fold paths, your desire, your achieving your desire will be in a proper manner, so that after the death you will have a good salvation of life. Okay, so this is the Gautama Buddha says Ashtamarga, or eightfold path. To achieve your desire without, and to overcome your suffering, you follow this eightfold path, which will make you to have a good attainment of a salvation. So this is the one teaching or one doctrine, so which we are having it. So next, the second teaching of Gautama Buddha we are having, so that is Nirvana. So what is this Nirvana, if you see? So according to Gautama Buddha, Nirvana is nothing but, It's nirvana is nothing but it's called as salvation. Salvation. So every religion you belongs to, or you may follow any of the religion, but every religion's main aim will be after the death you need to have a salvation. Okay, where you need, you always, everybody wish, you and me, everybody wish. Okay, we all wish after our death we need to reach a heaven. That's nothing but salvation. Okay. So, same thing here Gautama Buddha also says. Okay. It's not our ultimate goal of our life is to become a very rich person in the society and to have a big a lifestyle in society or recognized. No. Okay. Apart from all the things, it's all a part of life. But apart from all the things, after the death, the salvation is very important. Okay. So, Gautama Buddha says, if you want to have a salvation, a good salvation of life after your death, so he asks us to follow an eightfold path. Okay, that we had discussed already, eightfold path, so we have discussed. Okay, so the eightfold path, so which is being given by, the Gautama Buddhas, it's a main thing which he says for an ultimate goal of life. The eightfold path's main aim is the person to reach the ultimate goal of life. Your ultimate goal of life will be reaching a salvation. So it is everybody's ultimate goal. Okay. So here Nirvana, second teachings. Okay. The person or the religion or Buddhism, so they will have the ultimate goal of their life should be to reach salvation when they lead a life. When I lead a life or when I am leading a life, so my desire should be after my death, I should have a Nirvana, salvation of life. Or I should have good salvation of life, that should be there. So according to Buddha. Then eternal peace. Okay, harmony. Here also, once again it says, you should be a person who follows the path of Ahimsa. Then bliss. Bliss is nothing but blessings. Okay. Then be always a freedom from all worldly evils. It can be anything. Be honest. Have good attitude. Don't go behind the money. Don't go behind the evil things. All these things. We always should be away from the worldly evils. And freedom from cycle of birth and death. If you don't have a good salvation, that means when a person dies, if a person, he is not having good salvation of life, once again he will have a cycle of birth. Again he will have a cycle of, chain of birth and death will take place again and again. Okay, that is the freedom from. So if you want, to reach salvation of life after your death, or if you don't want a rebirth, then you need to have an all this life so should be there. Okay, that is the reason. So Gautama Buddha says, let your life should have an ultimate goal. So that goal should be, your goal should be to reach salvation. Your goal should be to follow a path of eternal peace. Your goal should be to be blessed. And your goal should be to lead your life being away from the worldly evils. And very important thing is freedom from a cycle of birth and death. So according to Gautama Buddha, if you want to have a freedom from cycle of birth and death, so he says, peaceful states of mind is the only one which can make a person to have a good salvation of life. Once if you reach to heaven, you will not have rebirth. Okay, so it's a faith of a religion. If you don't reach, you will have a cyclic chain of birth. Again you will be born, again you will have a death, then again you will have a rebirth. Again and again a person will be born. Okay, this is the logic of our Nirvana. Okay, this is the second teaching, he says. So next class, so we will go with some more, teachings. Thank you.